Excited to welcome the new Colts assistant offensive line coach, Kevin Mawae. Great to have you here in Indianapolis. A Pro Football Hall of Famer yourself, spent 16 seasons in the NFL. After the conclusion of your own playing career, what ultimately pulled you back into coaching and into the NFL?
Time away from the game. No, I weaned myself out of the game. I went to college coaching. I interned at Vanderbilt for a year, coached high school ball for a year, purposely took a year off, coached junior high for 2 years, and then I was doing internships along the way. And I knew I would at one time, but my kids were in high school. I was hoping they would get out before I got into coaching career, and that's what kind of what happened. So was with the Chicago Bears for training camp in 16. They hired me for the season, and then that was it. And so from there, I moved to Arizona State, joined the staff with Herm Edwards, whom I played for, and it was kind of a coincidental thing. My daughter was a student athlete that was recruited to Arizona State. We ended up there because of her, and I ended up on staff.
So what sport?
She's a swimmer. She's actually in conference championships right now. She swims for University of Hawaii now. She's since transferred, but I don't know when this is going to air, but but she's swimming at UH right now, yeah.
Well, good luck to the Mawae family. Good luck to her in the conference championships for sure. Going back to coaching junior high football, junior high and high school football, how much does that test your patience when you have that high standard of success in the NFL?
The challenge for somebody that played at our level, my level, is that you have to simplify football to a point where anybody can understand it. And so I tell people, if they're going to get into coaching, if you can't coach fifth and sixth graders, you can't coach at this level. Because your idea is you want to be able to communicate in such a simple way that everybody understands it. And like, you can't go 16-year NFL vet on a sixth grader. It doesn't happen. So you got to. It's keep it simple, stupid. It's a very simple principle. And if I can teach a fifth grader how to block a jet sweep, I can teach anybody how to block it. So that was my mentality.
You mentioned you spent those past few seasons there at Arizona State with this opportunity to join the Indianapolis Colts. What was most appealing about this role?
Well, I think for me, it just happened. I wasn't looking for it. I wasn't chasing it. It was circumstances that and doors opened up and it was an opportunity to come here. And I think the biggest difference between the college game and pro game is you don't recruit. Recruiting is a 24/7 deal. And you got a second phone tied to your hip, and you're talking to 15 and 16 year olds and 17 year olds all the time, and here it's all ball. It's all ball, and it's every sport is geared towards winning a championship, but here it's come in, do your work, go home, you know, that kind of thing. And college is, you never leave it. It's with you till midnight. You know, you're on the West Coast, you're talking to a kid on the East Coast and things like that, so you're always, you know, on call.
In your own NFL career, in 13 of your 16 seasons, you blocked for a 1,000-yard rusher, 5 different running backs over that period of time. When you look at the potential for this group of running backs with guys like Marlon Mack and Jonathan Taylor, what's most exciting about this in coaching this offensive
line? Well, I think there are two different types of running backs, and what I've seen in the film I've watched so far. But you can't just look at the two running backs. I think you got to look at the whole picture. The offensive line here is pretty special. But watching these guys play together as a unit is what's really special. I mean, it's great that you have great running backs and you struggle at offensive line. Or you have a great offensive line and don't have that special running back. Or you don't have a quarterback. And so it's more of the whole puzzle as opposed to just the individual parts. So that's what I'm excited about seeing. Last year at ASU, we had two really special running backs that complemented each other well. And it's like a lot what I see with these two guys here. But again, I think it goes back to the whole package with offensive line play and whoever that new quarterback's going to be.
One of the things that has been so special about this offensive line has been the continuity. When you have the retirement of Anthony Costanzo at left tackle, you're going to have a new guy in that position going into 2021. How do you create that continuity? What's it going to take to get that unit up to speed?
Well, whatever moves are made, there's going to be one new guy, whether he's a free agent guy or a draft pick or whatever. And in the limited time that I've been here, and I've been around Coach Frank and Chris Ballard and Chris Strasser, it's about finding the right fit, about finding the right guy. You can be a phenomenal player, but if you just don't fit with these guys, then there's going to be a challenge. So it becomes a more of a chemistry kind of thing. Are you the right guy that fits this room? And if you are, then And that's kind of the feel I got about this whole organization. It's everybody's got to fit in the right spot. And so I think that's where the challenge comes. And what I've seen about this organization from afar, that challenge will be met.
with the fit and chemistry, how do you explain the dynamic that there is between yourself and Chris Strasser, how you guys balance each other out and what you bring into that room?
Chris is unique. I met him through legendary O-line coach Howard Mudd, whom I played for with the Seattle Seahawks, and I met Chris through Howard. And so I've been able to see him go to the Denver Broncos and see what he did there and then come here. And so when the opportunity came here, to come here, opened up, I was very intrigued by it because I know there's similarities in the way I was taught, the way I coach, and what Chris teaches. And so I think we'll complement each other well. The difference being is I played it, and he's coached it for a very long time. And I think when you play at this level, for a guy like Ryan or for a guy like Hugh or, you know, any of those guys up front, you bring a different perspective. And that's, I'm just there in Louisiana, we call it lagniappe. It's a little something different, a little something extra. And so that's what I bring. I bring the experience that I did it. So maybe the X's and O's and the fundamentals are this, but have you tried this? It's a little something different. And I think that's what I bring to it. And it's a compliment.
Coach, so exciting to have you here in Indianapolis. Excited for more fantastic conversations, perspective from you moving forward. So welcome to Indianapolis.
Thank you. I'm excited about being here. I think I look pretty good in blue.
Look great in
blue. Yeah, it's a little different. I know our friends down south, there's people have some trouble with this, but, you know, this is a mercenary league. You go to who pays you. So that's what it is.
It'll grow on them. They'll catch up.
There's no doubt about it. They'll like seeing me down there. So it's all good.